Welcome everyone. In this lecture, I will discuss about some examples regarding the entropy change and some more concepts of the entropy. And this discussion is from the book of Garg, Bansal and Ghose. At first, we will consider a process Joule expansion. So, let us look at this figure, and we are considering a free expansion of a perfect gas into vacuum. Now, left to itself, a gas initially in the state depicted in figure 7.8a will end up in the state depicted in figure 7.8b. So, suppose there is a perfect gas here, and this gas is let to expand freely. So after some time, what will happen, this gas will expand it and will fill up the whole chamber, and after some time the chamber will look like this. And we are assuming the whole system is thermally insulated from the surroundings. These are the insulation. So these insulations actually is used to insulate the chamber from the surrounding. Now, we know that for such a case, internal energy U will be constant, and we wish to calculate the increase in entropy of the gas at temperature T when its volume changes from V1 to V2, but the pressure has decreased. So, here in this case, the volume changes. Volume has been increased. However, as the gas has been expanded, that is why the pressure has decreased. Since the system has been thermally insulated, that is, there is no heat exchange. That is why delta Q should be zero, and the change in entropy will be less than zero because work is done by the gas. As the gas is expanding, so the work is done by the gas, and change in entropy will be less than zero. But we must remember that the relation dS is equal to delta Q by T does not hold true for an irreversible process. However, since entropy is a state function, we may replace this irreversible expansion by some reversible process connecting the initial and final states. So we are assuming the process is a reversible one. A convenient way to choose an isothermal expansion from the initial volume to the final volume, and we can use the following equation, that is, we have already deduced this equation, delta S, that is equal to S2 minus S1, that is equal to integration of delta Q by T, and here volume is being expanded from V1 to V2. Now we know that dQ is equal to dU plus pdV for reversible process, and we can write P is equal to RT by V, that is equation for the ideal gas. In that case, we can write delta S is equal to V1 to V2 dU plus pdV by T. Now we know that dU is equal to 0 for an isothermal process. So ultimately this expression becomes delta S is equal to 1 by T V1 to V2 pdV, that is R ln V2 by V1. Now, proceeding further, we note that V2 greater than V1, as volume is being expanded, so V2 must be greater than V1. It means that delta S is positive. That is, the entropy of the gas increases in isothermal expansion, although there is no heat flow. This would also be the entropy increase in Joule expansion. So, we can note that in this process, the entropy of the surrounding does not change as there is no thermal interaction. Hence, the increase in entropy of the universe in Joule expansion is also given by this equation. Now, we will discuss about the entropy form of the first law. Now, the first law states that dQ is equal to dU plus dW, or dU is equal to dQ minus dW. So what is dW? dW is the work done, and the form of the work done delta W can be written in terms of two variables, that is, suppose x xi into dxi, where xi is the intensive variable parameter and capital Xi is conjugate extensive variable. For example, delta W is equal to P into dV. So in general, delta W can be expressed as sum of Xi into dxi, which will be of different form for different cases. Now we are writing in this way, that is this first equation, du is equal to dq minus xi into dxi. Now for a reversible process between two equilibrium states, we have from the second law, that is delta q is equal to t into ds. So du is equal to tds minus sum of xi into dxi. So this equation combines the first and the second law of thermodynamics for non-intensive interactions, and all variables occurring here are functions of states. And we can use this equation in different parts of the thermodynamics. For example, suppose we are going to calculate the entropy for an ideal gas, and from this equation, that is du is equal to tds minus sum of xi into dxi, we can write that is tds is equal to cvdt plus pdv. Here we have substituted du is equal to cvdt. So, and xi into dxi we have written in this form, that is p into dv. Here we have used small xi as small p. So, dxi is equal to dv. So, this is the equation to calculate the entropy for the ideal gas. And from this equation, we can calculate the change in entropy for ideal gas. We can rewrite this equation involving Cp. Here we have used Cv, but if you write the ideal gas equation Pv is equal to RT and differentiate it, for example, Pdv plus Vdp is equal to RdT, and using these two equations, we can write Tds equal to CpdT minus Vdp. And after we have these equations, we can also write Tds is equal to 1 by R Cp into P into dV plus Cp into V into dP. In this way, we can further simplify this equation and we can get different forms of the entropy change for ideal gas. We can take this as an exercise, but the thing is that these are the set of equations which has been obtained from the previous equation. This equation gives the change of entropy for the ideal gas. So we can look that there are different types of forms available. And this form, that is delta S is equal to Cp ln P V to the power gamma. So this is for adiabatic process, and if we consider isothermal process, then delta S can be written in this way, that is R ln V2 by V1 is equal to R ln P1 by P2. So there are different forms available to calculate the entropy change of an ideal gas. Now, let us discuss about the unavailable energy and thermal depth of universe. We discussed how irreversibility leads to loss of work output when a heat engine is operated under such conditions. We have already discussed about the topic of unavailable energy. The application of this idea to natural processes is of particular significance. We will now show that in every irreversible process, some energy becomes increasingly unavailable, that is, quality of energy is degraded. We can note that we have to express this result in terms of changes in entropy. Now, in the previous lecture, we have already deduced that how much energy is lost for an irreversible process. This was deduced in the earlier lectures. So that loss of energy is equal to T0 into Q by T2 minus Q by T1. In terms of entropy, we can rewrite this equation as loss of energy is equal to T0 into delta S. So what is T0? T0 is the temperature of the coldest available reservoir in the given environment. It may be the surroundings, it may be the surrounding air or surrounding lake, etc. So whatever it is, but T0 is the temperature of the coldest available reservoir in the given environment. And this expression, that is Q by T2 minus Q by T1, that is actually the increase in entropy of the universe. We have already deduced this expression, that is delta S, that is equal to Q into 1 minus T2 minus 1 by T1. We have deduced this equation in the earlier lecture. And this expression is the increase of entropy of the universe. From this, we may conclude that energy that is not available for work during an irreversible process is T0 times an increase in the entropy of the universe. So, from the equation 7.26, left hand side is the lost energy, that is energy that is not available for work. So, what is the amount of the energy? T0 times, it has been multiplied, T0 is multiplied with delta S. So, T0 times an increase in the entropy of the universe, because delta S is the entropy change of the universe. Since all natural processes are irreversible, energy available for work is continuously decreasing and entropy of the universe is piling up. Because we know that all natural processes are irreversible. So, as all processes are irreversible, so entropy will increase and ultimately this lost energy will also increase. So, what will happen ultimately, that is how long will entropy continue to increase and what is the future of our world? We expect that ultimately it will reach some upper limit, and the principle of increase of entropy implies that the universe is marching towards a stagnant thermal state to suffer thermal death. Now, we will discuss about the physical concept of entropy. It is likely that we may not have fully realized the significance of entropy yet after listening all the lectures. And we may also wonder as to what this quantity entropy is that is piling up in the universe. So, in this topic, what we will focus, we will give an insight about the physical and philosophical aspects of the entropy. Now, we may recall that entropy increases during an irreversible process. We have already discussed this fact so many times in the previous lectures. So, the word entropy serves as an effective vehicle for communicating our observations in respect of evolution of irreversible processes, like heat conduction along a bar or cooling of a cup of coffee. We have already discussed the heat conduction along a bar, and from that example, we have deduced that how much energy is lost for that particular irreversible process. And we have also shown that entropy has been increased in that process. We have also discussed about the cooling of a cup of coffee. During the cooling of the cup of coffee, the entropy also increases. We also know that entropy of a system increases when heat is added to it, because what is the expression of the entropy? dS is equal to dQ by T. So, if we add some heat, then entropy should definitely increase. Since heat is chaos, from kinetic viewpoint, continuous withdrawal of heat makes the molecular arrangement increasingly ordered. So, what is heat? Heat is basically chaos, that is random motion of the molecules from the kinetic theory viewpoint. Now, suppose there is some gas in some chamber, and what we are doing, we are continuously withdrawing the heat from this chamber. So, ultimately what will happen? The molecular arrangement will be ordered, because if you apply heat, then what will happen? The molecules will move randomly here and there. But if we do the opposite process, that is if we extract the heat from this chamber, then what will happen? The molecules in the gases will be highly ordered. That is, decrease in entropy implies a transition from chaotic state to some ordered state. So, if we make the chaotic state to an ordered state, so what will happen? The entropy will decrease. Conversely, more disordered the state is, the larger is the entropy. So disordered state has higher entropy. This implies that solids have much less entropy than gases. Why? Because in gases, the molecules move here and there in a random fashion. So there is no order of the molecules in the gases. However, in solids, the molecules or atoms are arranged in some periodic structure. That is, the arrangement of the atoms are very ordered in nature. That is why the solids have much less entropy than the gases. Another point to be made regarding entropy is that it can be related to the probability of occurrence of a particular state. For instance, increase in entropy is an irreversible process, and that can be associated with a change of state from a less probable to a more probable state. So, increase in entropy, we know that for an irreversible process, there is some increase of entropy. And due to the increase of entropy, we can say that the state is moving from a less probable to a more probable state. And we will explain this sentence with the help of some example. Now, see that we have already learned about Joule expansion of the gas. So, when there is some expansion of the gas, we will have some less information about the position coordinates of molecules after the expansion occurs. So, after the expansions, what happens? The molecules are in random order. That is, the final state is a less ordered state of the system. Why? Because after the expansions, molecules move here and there. So, their arrangement is random and the final state is less ordered state. So, what happened actually? So, Joule expansion is an irreversible process. So, after the expansion, that is, in this process, what happens? The system goes from a less probable state to a more probable one, because that random state occurs due to a natural phenomena, and that is actually the more probable state in case of Joule expansion, that is occurring freely, and random state is the more probable state. Now, we can recall that Joule expansion is associated with entropy increase. So, in this process, what happened? That entropy increases. Similarly, the most probable state when a cup of coffee cools is that it will be at the same temperature as its surrounding. So, suppose there is a cup of coffee which is hot. So, what is the most probable state? Most probable state is that after the some time, the cup of coffee will exchange some heat with the surroundings, and after the exchange of the heat, what will happen? That there will be equilibrium, that is, temperature of the coffee and the temperature of the surrounding will be equal. So, that state, that is the equilibrium state, is the most probable state. So, that is why in a natural process, the cup of coffee will always tend to be cooled down, and it will be at the equilibrium with the surroundings. Therefore, as coffee cools, entropy increases and the system changes from a less probable to a more probable one. So, when the state changes from a less probable to a more probable one, the entropy should increase. And we know that entropy increases in all irreversible processes. So, there is some relation between the entropy and the probability of a state. In fact, when a system is left to itself, it passes from an ordered state to a state of maximum disorder, that is most probable. Actually, this is the general phenomenon. I am again repeating this sentence because it is very important. That is, when a system is left to itself, that is, if we make the system so that the process occurs naturally. So, that is why it has been written, that is, when a system is left to itself, that is, we will not apply any force, the process will occur naturally. So, in that case, what will happen? It passes from an ordered, that is, least probable state, to a state of maximum disorder, that is the most probable. That is, a system has a tendency to change in the direction of increasing entropy. So, a natural process will occur in such a way so that the system will go to the direction of increasing entropy, so that the disorder is increased in the final state. This argument led Boltzmann to relate entropy with probability. Mathematically, he expressed it by the relation S is equal to function of W, where S and W respectively denote the entropy and thermodynamic probability of the state. Lastly, so you may inquire, that is, does the second law of thermodynamics apply to the universe as a whole? If this were true, how did it get in the state of low entropy? And are some processes going on in the universe elsewhere that compensate for increase in entropy? But however, the answers of these questions are really very difficult, and we have to collect some more information regarding thermodynamics to discuss these questions, and we will discuss these questions in some later lectures. And thank you all for listening this lecture.